here, welcoming you to a bit of a different video today. I've done a couple of these in the past with Real Madrid and Barcelona. I thought today I would do one with Bayern Munich. As you can see, we are in 2018, and we've got the 2018 Bayern Munich squad. It's not too far into the future. It's not too much of a jump, because I did want some of the players like Robben, Ribery, Lahm, Schweinsteiger. I wanted them all to still be a decent rating. So we're going to go through the team very quickly, starting off with Lewandowski up top. 90 rated, absolute beast, as per usual with Lewandowski. He's 30 years old now, so I did want him at his peak, and he hasn't actually hit higher than 90. Robben, 92 at the age of 34, keeping all his physical stats nice and high. He's got great skill attributes. Of course, Robben is a quality player. I'm glad to see that he kept his physical stats and his overall, unlike Ribery, who did hit 90, but at the age of 35 is now decreasing with his 87 acceleration, 81 sprint speed. So he is decreasing quite rapidly now. He was 90 just a couple of seasons ago, maybe I think a season ago, so he has dropped quite drastically. Mario Götze in the midfield, 88 rated at 26 years old. I'm sure he could hit maybe a little bit higher than that. Of course, a very well-rounded player, great stats everywhere, can play central midfield as well. That's the position he's playing today, left central midfield. On the right-hand side is Pierre-Emile Hojbjerg, or Hobberg, or however you pronounce that name. I don't know, I'm not sure which J's are silent, which J's you pronounce. But he is an absolute beast. The Danish central midfielder can play defensive, attacking, or right in the middle of midfield. He's got very well-rounded stats. He's an incredible player. And he's really the only young player that grew, to be honest with you, in these last couple of years. And you see what I mean, because most of this team is pretty much the starting squad. In central midfield, we have Philipp Lahm, the skipper, at 34 years old. That's 87 rated. He did go up to about 89, I believe it was. It could have been 88. But he dropped back down to an 87, which is his initial rating. Of course, he can play right back as well. But in right back position, we put Boateng, because he can play there. And I did want to play all three of the quality center backs in Boateng, Martinez, and Benacia. So I did want to play Boateng right back. I might switch that up in the actual game that we're going to play today, because he's not too quick, but he's an absolute tank. You look at his defensive stats, 89 stand tackling, 91 slide tackling. He's very, very good, of course, 6'4", German, and he's a beast. So I'm not sure I'm going to be playing him at right back. I think Martinez is the one that is going to get dropped. I might play Bernat at right back. But carrying on with the team, we have Javi Martinez, who is quite a beast. Center back, of course, he did come from a defensive midfield position. He used to play that for, who did he play for in Spain? Bilbao, I want to say, but I could be wrong there. But yeah, center back, defensive mid, and central midfield, of course, as you can see. He's good. His pace is the only thing that really lacks, but he's a very good central defender. You know, 88 stand tackling, 91 slide tackling. He's a brick. He's 6'3". He's pretty good, but I would put Boateng ahead of him, so I might switch out for the game. Next to him is Benacia from Morocco, of course, 31 years old now. Bit better pace than Javi Martinez, and he's much better tackling-wise than both other centre-backs, with 94 stand and slide tackling, with 93 marking as well. 90 headering accuracy, 6'3", as I said before, from Morocco. He's an absolute unit, this guy, and I can't wait to get into the game with him. And next to him is David Alaba, who's still 26 years old, still could get up a couple. I have seen him at like the likes of 88 and 89, so it is possible, and he can play centre-back as well, so imagine that. Very versatile player, probably one of the most versatile players in the world right now. Guardiola has said that he can play attacking mid, right mid, left mid, right back, center back, defensive mid, central mid, left back, pretty much anywhere but a striker. But even then, I reckon you could play him as a striker. He's got amazing stats, as you can see. He's finishing at 65, and take a look at that. Everything is yellow. His strength, his finishing, and his volleys are the only thing below 70 rating, I guess you can say. And they're all within range. You know, 3 more for volleys, 5 more for finishing, and 4 more for strength. Imagine all green stats on a left back. Could be absolutely brilliant in a couple of years, this guy. And of course, as I said, playing in the left back position today. On the bench, we have Muller. Still 28 rated, he definitely will be coming on as a substitute in this game. Center forward, right mid, attacking mid, and striker. Where I'm going to bring him on, I'm not quite sure. I might bring him in as a right mid and then switch Robben to left mid to give Ribery a bit of a break. I'm not sure. But of course, great stats from Muller. You guys know what he's about. He's an absolute beast. 88 finishing as well, not bad at all. 83 volleys, of course, is not bad. Again, very well-rounded player, Muller. Central midfield backups, we have Schweinsteiger. I do want to play this guy. I did want to play him ahead of Lahm, but Lahm is the captain, and so I've decided that. He's an absolute unit, this guy. He's an absolute beast. 83 stamina, 90 reactions. He's got a hell of a long shot in it. 88 long shot. He's got the passing and everything. He's just a very well-rounded player. The only thing that he lacks, of course, is pace. But even then, it's not too bad. It's bad, but it's not too terrible. Thiago is the other central midfielder. Another well-rounded player, but he's not as defensive as I would like him to be. I thought Thiago might have improved his defensive stats at FC Bayern, but of course he has not done that. He can play defensive mid, attacking mid, or central mid, and he's probably going to get a couple minutes, maybe, depending on injuries or not. I might not play him. Schweinsteiger might be the only substitute I make in the midfield. But I've also put Gordino here, who's the son of a legend, but he himself is not a legend yet. Attacking mid or central mid. This is one of the young players that I thought would increase in overall. Unfortunately, he's still 73 rated. It is higher than his initial rating, which is, I believe, somewhere in the 60s. So he has improved, but not to the capacity that I would like. He's got great pass, short passing stat anyway. Decent dribbling, ball control. On the ball, he's not bad. But, you know, just not what I expected from him. I did expect a bit more from Gord, you know. In at left back is Bernat, who's got brilliant stats. And I probably might play him at right back today. Despite being a left-footed left back, I might play him at right back. He's done that a couple times in his career, but he is left-footed, as you can see, with three-star weak foot. So probably not the best idea to play him right back. But I might do that ahead of Boateng. Play Boateng instead of Martinez and chuck Martinez on the bench. I think that'll be the best decision going into this game. Mitchell Weiser is another young player that I expected to grow a bit more than he did. And unfortunately, he did not. Right mid, left mid, and right back. Still 73 rated at his age. I would have expected him to be in the high 70s by now, if not cracking 80. Reina, we don't have to go through his stats. And I'm pretty much not going to go through any of these people's stats either. You've got Dante, Badstuber, Scholl, Kurt, Rafinha, Vyrauch, Green, who I would have expected to be a lot... Same with Vyrauch here. I would expect him to be a lot higher rated. Same with Green. Kirchhoff, who's actually grown quite a bit, is a bit of a beast. And then pretty much the rest of these are all youth players. You've got Sebastian Rode there, who I could actually bring in instead of Gordino or Thiago, but I doubt he would play, but he is an incredible player. Very, very underrated. A lot of people don't give this guy a chance. I think he just signed for Bayern Munich, so you might not be able to buy him in the first season, but look at these stats. He's a brilliant box-to-box midfielder. You can play him in defensive as well. High work rate, and he's just an absolute machine. But that pretty much wraps up the squad overall. Today we have a Champions League game against Manchester United in the group stages. They're in our group. We're going to get into this game. Just one game to show off the team and how they play. And yeah, we're going to check it out and see how it goes. I realized I forgot to go through Manuel Neuer's stats. So who they are really, really quickly before the game starts. 85 jumping, 88 reactions, 83 strength, 90 diving, 88 handling, 92 kicking, 93 positioning, and 87 reflexes. 93 rated Manuel Neuer at the age of 32. Now we can start the game now that we've gotten all the ratings out of the way. Patient build-up. Hojbjerg finds Robben. Oh, that's a penalty for sure. For sure. Who was that went in there? Is it Nani? Is it actually Nani who's gone for a slide tackle thinking he could take it off Robben? What a clown. Nani's given us a penalty very early on in this game, and it's Lewandowski who's gonna step up versus David De Gea, who's still at Manchester United. Let's hope that's how it is in real life. Come on, Lewandowski, bury this. Oh, that's not the best placing, actually. Oh, De Gea just had to stand there and gobble it up. Oh, I can't believe I didn't convert the penalty. No one really making a run. Flicks it over to Ribéry. Oh, that's a ball. That is a Bruno. Look at this counter-attack from Manchester United. They got men pouring forward. It's Di Maria who's run into the box, and Neuer with a solid save. There it is, half-time. It is 0-0, and I've just realized this is actually the Copa Europe, so we're the Champions League winners. We did beat, I think, Real Madrid last year, and Manchester United won the Europa League. Astore finds Di Maria, who's got a bit of room, takes the shot, it's past Manuel Neuer, who can't get down enough, and the Europa League winners are in the lead, 1-0 in the 60th minute, and it's got to be said, we have not broken the defence so far of Manchester United. Lewandowski's not leading the line the way I'd like him to, and I'm thinking of bringing Muller on at the moment, because we have struggled going forward. Nothing Neuer can do about that. It's a brilliant strike from Di Maria off a great bit of play there. Ribery crosses it in. Bernaccia's there. Oh, and it's a deflection. Bernaccia is very good on those headers, and it's lucky there was a deflection by Pastore there. It's a long lob, and at the minute, it looks like United don't want the ball. They're willing to absorb the pressure. Ribery now. Hojbjerg. There's a run there to be made. It's Lahm. It's Phil Lahm. It's the captain who's put it away. It's 1-1. We're not going to die that quickly, Manchester. We're not going to die that quickly. The skipper makes a brilliant run, splitting the defense. And finally, we get the goal that we've been waiting for. Great work from the youngster Hojbjerg, or not so much youngster anymore. And it's a brilliant pass. De Gea trying to do the best he can, but Phil Lahm tucks it past him. What a goal, 1-1. And this game just got interesting. Who stripped somebody? Robben finds Muller. I forgot who was it. I think it was Luke Shaw that he stripped. And it's Muller now, 1-on-1, unfortunately. Oh, he does get around. Passes it back to Goetze, who's just sitting there. Under Herrera gets in the way. It's fallen to Robben. Shoot, son. Oh, my God. De Gea gets up in time. And you were just wondering why Iron Robben didn't shoot straight away. And De Gea gets in position and makes a beautiful save. And that could have been 2-1. Shaw again. Bernat with a first-time cross. Muller's there, and it's De Gea with the save. Swings it out. Bernaccia is there. Oh, and it's gone. Snuck in. It has actually snuck in off the crossbar. Bernaccia, in the 99th minute, has put Bayern Munich 2-1 up. Is that it? Do United have anything left? Do they have a response? We've been knocking at the door in extra time, and it's gone in. 2-1 off the crossbar. And whoever is there at the near post, eat your heart out. You couldn't reach. I think it's Daily Blind. And it's Bernaccia with a brilliant header off his 88 headering accuracy. That's why he's there. And he's put us up 2-1. Muller's continued going. It's Raphael who's completely missed the challenge. He's cut in. He's going for it. Oh, it's a horrible effort from Thomas Muller. But nevertheless, it's the 120th minute. No added minutes. And that's it. We've won 2-1 with the Bayern Munich side. 76th and 99th minute were the goals. And Manchester United put up a decent fight, but that was it. And let's take a look at some stats and the player ratings. As you can see, 12 shots, 9 on target. We were by far the more offensive team. Equal share of possession, and United had opportunities that they just didn't put away. They had crosses that they missed, build-up plays that were just, you know, found out, you know, we got the ball back and they just weren't able to produce any shots from it. And that pretty much wraps up this episode, guys. If you did enjoy this video, make sure you smash a like down below. The two other ones that I've done did fairly well, but I believe that's because it was earlier on in FIFA. I'm not sure if people will still be up for these kind of videos. I do want to test out a couple of other teams, but Bayern Munich, I thought I'd do. Very disappointing team compared to Real Madrid and Barcelona, whose young talents just absolutely smashed it. They were making it into the first team, and I actually did have more fun playing with those players. Unfortunately, in this team, the only real, you know, not first team player that made it into the first team on the ratings and on the stats was Hojbjerg, unfortunately. So, a bit disappointing that we didn't have the likes of Mitchell Weiser or someone like a Weirouch or a Julian Green or something like that really break out. It was just Hojbjerg who was able to. So quite disappointing, but if you did enjoy it, nevertheless, smash a like down below. I'll see you guys in the next career mode vid or other video very soon. Keep it real.